We have all the pinakauna the Moro National Liberation Front leaders ng entire Region 11. Ikalawa, nandito ang GBI mainstream, Democratic Society of Crime Busters. Nandito ang Supreme Tribal Council of Peace and Development, mga luma. So nakikita natin, at saka nandito yung Marlica Revolutionary Forces. So this is sectoral. Walang politiko, sectoral boses ng mga tao. So yan ang nandito ngayon, mga leaders.
Ano yung objective, sir? Ano yung itidiklaro na alliance?
Nagkakaisa para makuha, matuldukan ang conflict na matagal na. Na may isang tao na pinagkakatiwalaan ng hindi lang sa Mindanao, sa buong mundo, na huwag na natin palampasin. So, isang solusyon ang nakikita dito para lahat ay magkaisa. Kailangan isuporta natin si Mayor Duterte para ma-post natin yung federalism, which is the alternative solution, itong decayed problem. So ito I will read my statement. Decades have passed since the very first Moro resistance was waged against the Philippine government, driven by the desire to emancipate from the oppression and marginalization of the Moro people in their own homeland. Since then, countless of Moro freedom fighters have already fought to the grave. Yet the Bangsa Moro dream long and fought by the Moro brothers and sisters remain unfulfilled. At present, the struggle of poor emancipation continues. However, this time, we the Moros are not alone. This time, our fellow aborigines and heirs of Mindanao, the Lumads, as well as the Christian sympathizers of the Bangsa Moro cause, who have long been sons and daughters of Mindanao, have joined us in fighting for the common objectives of liberating the Mindanaoan people from oppression, injustice, and underdevelopment. We, the people of Mindanao, have come to the realization that this is not only the battle of the Moros, but the battle of the Mindanaoan people in putting an end on the age-long neglect and oppression of the national government towards our people. We desire to have a kind of government wherein the needs and interests of our people are genuinely addressed. A type of governance wherein the people themselves are empowered and motivated to mainstream their diverse interests. And a government system whereby our people shall be able to feel and benefit on the economic undertakings they have employed in their localities. A call for federalism. This political objective would remain unrealized unless we will have a leader who holds similar vision and aspirations for our people. And today we are honored and grateful that there is somebody who understands the battle we are fighting for as Mindanaoans and is willing to spearhead the change we have longed for. Now there is a brave soul who is willing to hurdle and transform the Manila-centric politics of our country. Now, there is a selfless man who is willing to dedicate his twilight years in remaining public service, not only to the Damawenyos, but to all Filipinos, regardless of race, ethnicity, beliefs, and traditions. Thus, as Mindanaoans, it is not a choice, but it must be incumbent for us to support Mayor Duterte, for he is fighting for our battle and cause. In the end, if Mindanao, in the land of promise, we, the sons, the daughters and of Mindanao, would fight to experience and feel the promise brought by our very own homeland, this can only be initially attained by supporting Mayor Rodrigo Duterte for president. Wabillahi taufiq wal hidayah. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
The platform of Mayor Duterte to fight against drugs and corruption and criminality. What will be the role of the MNLF?
We are ready. The MNLF is ready for any eventualities. He will just follow his heart, follow his intuition, and we are always ready. Yes, of course. By the way, our chairman of the MNLF and founding leader has already declared, and downline to our camps, followers, sympathizers, we assured that in our areas controlled by the MNLF, 100% Duterte. Kung maaari lang, zero ang kalaban. And not only we will vote, we will campaign, and we will protect the votes of our people to assure and deliver the votes for Mayor Duterte for president.
Sir, dati kasi sir, may kumakalat na information na if Mayor Duterte could not win, is there a possible revolution from the side of Moros and also as well as from the MPs? Is there a possible? What do you think,
sir? A very big possibility. That's why we come up now. This is a declaration and, of course, consultation to the people, that the intuitions of our beloved mayor will become true if he will be cheated in this coming election. Now, as you look at this, there are revolutionary now coming in. Hindi lang Christian. Hindi lang Muslim, lahat ng sektor na ngayon, they will stand. Because it is incumbent for us, Mindanaoan, we have to choose our own kind. Hindi na natin palagpasin ito. This is the real chance. This is the real time